Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to answer, how thick does spray foam insulation need to be? Well, simply put, it really depends on where it's being applied and what you're trying to accomplish. Now, generically speaking, we typically recommend open cell be 6 inches thick on a roof or ceiling application and 3 inches on walls. And with closed cell, we usually recommend 4 to 5 inches on a ceiling and 2 to 3 inches on walls. Now, these numbers may surprise some of you, and we get calls quite a bit with people requesting things as thick as 10 or 12 inches of closed cell on a roof deck. Some people call in asking for that, or 5 to 6 inches on their walls. It's not uncommon at all. Here's the question that really comes into play is, what are you trying to do? And almost everyone, when you're trying to put insulation in, you're just trying to establish an air seal, get good thermal resistance, and that's it. Now, you want those things ultimately to save money and have an energy efficient home or pole barn, but that's your goal, right? Is to save money and be energy efficient. Well, when you over insulate and you put 10 inches of closed cell on your ceiling, what you're doing essentially is wasting money. After you reach a certain threshold, you do not see any return on that money. There's a certain point where you diminish your returns. So where we found is those marks that I mentioned. We get those measurements from the manufacturer. That's what they recommend to use. So open cell, 6 inches on your ceiling, establishes an air seal and provides adequate thermal resistance. Same thing, closed cell, 4 to 5 inches, establishes an air seal and gives you good enough thermal resistance. Walls, same thing like I mentioned before. So if you are looking at a project and you're thinking, man, I want more spray foam because it has a good R value, and the more R value you get, the better insulation quality. That's not the case. R value does matter. However, thermal resistance is what R value loosely measures. Now, if you have an air seal, that's the more important thing, is to establish an air seal. Spray foam does that, whether you're using open cell or closed cell. So again, stacking R value on top of R value on top of R value, at a certain point, your returns will diminish. And like I said, you're just wasting money. Now, us as a contractor, the last thing we want to see is a customer wasting money. The whole thing that we're trying to do here is provide a service and product that will save homeowners money. So we really don't want people installing foam more than they need to, just, you know, to make them feel good. So we always try to educate everyone and let them know, if you're going to use open cell, 6 and 3 is usually a good way to go. Closed cell, like I said, 4 to 5, depending on the building, 2 to 3 on the walls, again, depending on the building type. But again, going more than that, you're just not gonna see the return on that investment. And again, the last thing we wanna see as a contractor is a customer wasting money. Hope this information was helpful to you. If you have any questions about how thick you should go on your particular project, leave us a comment, tell us about it. We'd love to get more in detail with you. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget, hit that bell. Quick message for all the dads out there. I know you want to leave your thermostat at 62 degrees. I get it. Insulating your home with foam is the easiest way to do that. That's what the French call a win-win.